keep the gospel reading. Who has? On a gospel passage here on the screen. Okay. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. How are you?
Thank God.
Which one?
Thank God.
The gospel you just heard is a very famous gospel. Jesus is feeding the 5,000, right? Anybody didn't hear about this gospel before? We know it all, right? Tonight, we are going to do something different. Why we read the Bible? Anybody can tell me why we read the Bible? Yes. God is speaking to us. Prayer, speaking to God. But when we read the Bible, God is? Okay. Bible is all about knowledge, or the Bible is a way of life. What do you think, Bavli? When you read the Bible, what you get out of it? Listening to God. God is speaking to us. I'll tell you a story. Let us start with a story. There were three people. They went to be monks. So they told them, we want to examine you if you can be a monk or not. And what they did, they give each one of them a Bible. And they give them a month. And they told them, do whatever you want to do with the Bible for a month, and come back, we will ask you what you did. The first one said, you will be so proud of me. I took the Bible, and I made another copy. You know, old days, the Bible was not printed. It's manuscripts, handwriting. So he took the month, day and night, writing another copy of the Bible. And the abbot of the monastery told him, thank you, you filled the monastery with papers. Imagine you did all this effort, and the answer, thank you, you filled the monastery with papers. The other one came and told him, listen, I think you will love me. You know, those papers, they can be stolen, they can burn, whatever. I memorized the Bible. Imagine, I memorized the Bible. And the abbot told him, sorry, you filled the air with words. You filled the air with words. And the third one came and told him, I'm so sorry, Father. He told him, why? He told him, I started to apply what is in the Bible in my life. And the whole month, I didn't finish one verse. He told him, you are the one to stay with us, because the rest of your life will be converting the God's teaching in the Bible into life. That's why the Christians, they are called living Bibles. When I see anybody, when I see scholars, I see jihad, love. When I see the Holy Virgin humility and humbleness, right? When I see Carolus, I see Jesus' obedience when he was young. This is what we want to see. And today I'm going to teach you how to get the life out of the Bible. We are going to do a very simple exercise. You have the gospel passage today, tonight, in front of you. And I need anyone you read and tell me what kind of teaching you are getting from this passage and gonna apply in your life. I did this homework before I came, and I got 10 things. How many are gonna give me? 10 or more? I'm learning from you. Okay. Who want to start? Who want to start? Serious people. You want me to ask names or? Okay, let's start with the grown-ups. Lovely. what you are learning from this passage, what you can take after you read the Bible, and you can take with you and say, I'm gonna practice this in my life. Everybody think about it. I will not go to any, each one of you, wait till he thinks. Okay? Each one of you read the passage, and I want you to tell me, when you read it, what you're gonna get out of it, what you're gonna take with you after you close the Bible. And this is how to convert the words of the Bible into life. And this is what I want you to do in your daily reading of the Bible. Miriam. Ah, Michael. If you want to learn, go to Jesus. I love you. This one is not in my 10, by the way. who gonna write? Good handwriting. You have a good handwriting? Come. Wait. The pens are here. If you want to learn, go to Jesus. Number one. So here, I feel the Bible is my food for my spirit. I want to read. I want to know every word Jesus said to learn and learn and learn. So the first one you're going to write is, if you want to learn, go to Jesus. Number two. Guys. Yes. Always have faith. Yes, the disciples at the beginning, they didn't. But when they saw the miracle, they have faith. Number two, always have faith. Yes. Yes. You have to read here. You have to read this passage. Yes, Bavli. Go to God and God will provide. Okay, go to God and he will provide. Ask God, ask or go, okay. Go to God and he will provide. Yes. So when you say this, Bavli, what do you have? Heart. You will feel you are missing a portion or missing, or you feel as long as I'm with God, I have everything. You believe? You believe in this? Okay. Yes. Yes, they said it. Have faith. Yes. Yes.
To speak to God, you have to go to a deserted place. You have to empty yourself.
Yes. Importance of privacy. Privacy with God. So here, personal prayer, or you can say importance of quiet time. Importance of quiet time. See, I'm learning. Yes. You need to speak. Tell me anything. Have faith, they said. I love you. Obey. Number five, thank you. Obedience. Obedience. The disciples brought for him 5 loaves and 2 fishes. Bring it. This needs high level of obedience. And he told the people to sit in 50s. And this is another. What do you have in your hand to let people sit in 50s? No. He will do something. Obey God.
Be patient with God?
I don't know how to formulate. Be patient with God. God is the most patient. Yes.
Always believe in him.
They said it. Have faith. Yes. Yes. Don't tell God what to do. Don't tell God what to do. Yes. Why? They will see it in you. Guys. Yes. God has always solutions. Okay. God has always solutions. This is very important because many times we need to understand what we're going to do. Or we tell him what to do. I want you to do this. And if he doesn't do it, then we have a problem. While in reality, he does things we don't understand how. This is the link between the two scenarios is faith. By faith, you will see Moses leading 2 million out of Egypt. There was no tunnels, there was no bridges, just the sea. Moses had a plan in front of him, the sea, and he has a miraculous stick. All what he did, he split the Red Sea, right? So this doesn't work with anybody. Doesn't work with anybody, cannot think about it. Huh? What else? Yes. I love you. This is a nice one. Love, care, and share. Write this. Love, care, and share. How? The disciples, they didn't tell the people to leave. They let them share the spiritual teaching of the Lord. And after they felt it is going to be dark, their love made them to go to Jesus to tell him, please let others go. But Jesus had another plan. Because Jesus, if you want to add one, Jesus takes care of you as a whole. He doesn't just teach spiritual things, but he gives you your body needs. Jesus takes care of you, spirit, soul, and body, right? And their love made them to share the teaching and the food, and their care made them to share as well. Thank you. What else? Still, we have a lot, but I'm really learning from you. What else? Yes. God gives us more than what we need. In the liturgy of St. Gregory, we say, "What you do more than we ask or understand. You do more than we ask or understand. You plan something, and you find God is having a better master plan for you." Yes. Huh? He saved us from sin. Yes. But it's not in here. Not in this. Can you raise your voice or come here? Yalla, before you forget what Camelia told you. Come.
The blessed of God, when you need him, you don't go hungry.
Okay. The power of the blessing of Jesus in our life. So you will not go hungry. Power of blessing of God. Bravo. That's a good one, because it's all about 5 loaves to feed 20,000. It's a power of blessings. Parents always at the beginning of the month, they see what their salary, and they see their bills, and it doesn't work. But the end of the month comes, and they are in a good shape. And the last year, they had the same story, and every month we have the same story. But it is a blessing of God. What else? Excellent. You have to do your part, because Jesus can do something very simple. He can stop the enzymes, digestive enzymes, in their digestive system, right? For a day. He kept the clothes and shoes of the Israelites 40 years untired in the wilderness. He can stop this, and he will not feel hungry. Simple, right? But he didn't do this. He asked for something. So here, Kevin, do your part. You have to come up with the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes. What else? Yes. The others come before you. I love you. The others, Kevin, the others come before you. Don't try it on my door, huh? The others come before you because the disciples thought about the multitude. And this is, I love you, this is very important because many times we just think about ourselves. We have very narrow vision. We don't see anybody other than ourselves. What else? Yes. I think we said it. We have faith. Yes. Running out of space. Okay. We'll see. Yes. We said it. Bravo. What else? Yes. God will come to you. Actually, they came to him. In this event, they came to him. Yes. We said it. Share, care, and share. Thank you. But you're thinking very, very wisely. Appreciate this. Alexa. Anything about Jesus' divinity? This doesn't tell you Jesus is God? Who can feed 20,000 from? Who can do this? Only God. So number 14, Jesus' divinity. He is God. Jesus is God. What else? At the beginning of the miracle, you see anything you can learn? Yes. Yeah, it is never late with God. Late outside is harmful, but late with Jesus, he will take care of you. What the disciples did when they came? Okay, it's not here. Thank you. This, if you read the part before this, they just came from their mission and they reported to him. Okay, don't write it. It's not in this passage. But it's never late with Jesus. He ran out of space. Okay. I have something important also I want to share with you. It's okay, Habib. It's okay. That's fine. What happened between Jesus and Philip and Jesus and Andrew? You call it what? Joseph. What happened between Jesus and Philip? Philip came to tell him, send them away. And he told him, give them food. He told him, no, 200 dinars is not enough. And Andrew came, just 5 loaves and 2 fishes. What we call this? Dialoguing. Many times we don't dialogue. You know what does it mean, dialogue? What is the difference between dialogue and monologue? You know what is the difference? I'm trying to build a dialogue with you. But when I speak by myself, it is a monologue. And many times we give orders and we don't share and listen. So important point here Jesus was teaching them is to dialogue and listen. Okay. It's not here, but when Jesus asked them to sit 50-50, when you look into your room and you find it messy, you tell yourself, Jesus ordered his disciple to set the multitude in 50s, and this we can say be organized. Okay. What Jesus did to bless the food, he did 3 things. Number 1 is thanking, thanksgiving. Number 2, blessed. Number 3, break. Any time you eat, you need to start before eating with the prayer, thanksgiving, thank God. Last thing I tell you is the last part. The last part. What happened in the last part? Yes.
There were 12 baskets left of food.
Why they have to collect 12 baskets while they have Jesus? He fed 20,000 people from 5 loaves. Do you think? I have a lot. I don't have to care about fractions. Right? You know, the trash we throw out from our homes, if you send it to Africa, people will feel they have festival. Right? Right? Why are you hiding? I want to see you. Huh? What does it mean, collect the fractions? And why 12 baskets? What does it mean, collect the fraction? What you do if you are eating and you don't feel finishing your plate? Huh? For 2-3 days, and then mom will come and put it in trash, right? See, he's honest. Some people, they will sneak it and put it in the trash behind their parents, right? I'm not joking. One day I give somebody a sandwich. He doesn't like what is in it. He didn't tell me. He felt sorry and bad to tell me. So what he did with the sandwich, he put it in the trash here. This is what we do. But there are people, they need this food. Collect the fractions. Collect the fractions means what? I don't want you to be tight, but I want you to know the value of small things. If I look to all of those, here we have 14, and I said few more. Each one of those is a lesson for you to practice in your life. Are you with me? Fuad, come here. Pick anyone and tell me how you're going to apply it in your life. Anyone from the 14 or what I added?
How going to apply it? Living Bible.
I'm going to choose number 5, obey God. Because, like, if I'm doubting, God's not hearing what I'm saying, like, prayers, like, when I'm, like, praying to God, and, like, I feel like, I'm not getting an answer back, like, maybe in the future, or, like, when God thinks, like, it's right, it's the right time, then, like, you'll have.
So, to obey God first, you need to know what he wanna from you.
Yeah.
So, you have to read the Bible regularly, right?
Yeah.
If you don't read the DMV guide for driving in California, you don't know. So, you do whatever. So, I have to read the Bible to obey God.
God.
Obey God.
Obey God.
You know God, to obey him, he told you, obey your parents. Are you going to do this?
Of course.
Thank you. I love you. Julie, come. Be ready, both of you. Pick one and tell me how you're going to apply it in your life.
Number eight,
saying what?
Love, care, and share. I will love and care
and share. Apply to your family. You have to
love, care, and share with my brother and sister and parents and friends and other people.
So we'll not fight for a piece of chocolate or for a new toy or a game or anything like this. Even if you don't, if you feel it's not fair, they are taking everything. Right? You agree with that?
Yeah.
You will help her to share and care?
Yeah.
Thank you. Miriam, come. Yes.
Jihad after her. No, he's Fadi, son of Jihad.
I'm going to do with number 2.
Number 2 is saying what?
Always have faith.
Okay.
And
let me dialogue with you. If you have an exam tomorrow, on Monday, how do you feel?
Scared.
Then you have to refer to rule number 2. Rule number 2 is saying what?
Have faith.
If you study, you don't get scared. Okay? If you're scared, you have either not studied or?
You don't have faith.
Thank you.
Do your part.
See, the principal said, do your part. Come here. Fadi, be ready, huh? Yeah. Pick one.
I'm going to go with number one.
Number one.
I'm going to go to Jesus when I need something.
This is a great thing because practically we go everywhere, and when it is no hope, we think of Jesus. Trust me, we go everywhere, but when it is dead end, then we think of Jesus, right? So anytime you have anything you're going to do, you will think of
Jesus.
Love you. Fadi, come here, Fadi. After him. Okay. Choose one, pick one, and tell me what you're going
to
do.
If you want to learn, go to Jesus.
How are you going to do this?
Anything that you want to learn, they could just go to Jesus.
Some physics, like, some math. You
no,
know?
Like.
Okay, let me give you a little advice. There are books in the Bible called the books of wisdom. Books of what? Wisdom. Anybody knows books of wisdom? Which books are the books of wisdom? Huh? No. Books of wisdom.
Genesis?
No. Books of wisdom. Yes. No. Huh? Anybody knows the books of wisdom? There are a few. Yusuf, Mr. Wise, tell me. Huh? Psalms, huh? Proverbs, huh? What else? Huh? Genesis, no. You know Joshua, son of Sirach? Joshua. Thank you, Fadi. Stefano. Okay. I am teaching you how to read the Bible and convert it into, huh? Alive. I want to see you living Bible, huh?
Number two, always have faith. If I don't know something, like I have a test in school, I don't know it completely, I have faith that God will give me an A.
I love you. Can you share your larynx with me? who want to come? Which one?
Number four
is saying?
Importance of quiet time.
Importance of quiet time.
So when you want to read the Bible, you have to be in a private place.
Yes.
And
you cannot open TV.
No.
Or you play with your iPad and reading the Bible, right? Good girl. Thank you. And Maj doesn't disturb you or his dad. Alexa, after him.
I'll go in number eight.
Number eight.
Love, care, and share. I'll love my parents with my heart and God, and then I'll care for my siblings, and then I'll.
Are you going to care for me?
Yeah. Okay. And then I'll share, like, if I have something and my brothers or sisters doesn't have it.
They're going to practice this?
Yeah.
No more fighting at home?
Maybe.
Maybe? Alex. Okay. Yeah, quickly. Which one?
Love, care, and share.
Yes.
Because if somebody doesn't have a snack, you can go share with them.
If he has a snack, I will share with him.
No, if he doesn't.
Because I'm sharing. Or if you have a snack.
If I have a snack, yeah, and the other person
okay. This is okay with me. The first one is different. You're great. Good job. Come.
I'll go with always have faith. Because sometimes if you get scared or something, have faith.
Yes.
Don't be scared that something might happen, like you could just get hit in the head out of somewhere.
Okay, so if you got scared, then your faith is little. Huh? Who else want to share? Come here.
I'm going to go with number 7. God always has solutions, because if you don't have, if you have a problem and you don't know, you don't have a good answer to it, you can pray to God.
Do you have any problems? Have you?
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
If I can't figure out something.
Have faith, huh?
Yeah.
تعالب شوي كم.
I'm gonna go with.
I want you to read the Bible and,
pray.
Apply it to your life. This way we will change. Otherwise, we read and forget. Yes.
I'm gonna go with number 2, because usually when I have tests, even though I study, I'm still really scared, and I'm just like.
So when you have tests, you don't have to be scared. If you studied.
I study by, so I'm scared.
No, don't have fear. Okay. Well, who else? Sylvain, come.
I'm going to go with number 8, love, share, and care, or love, care, and share, because...
So if you do love, share, and care, Mark will not have any problem. Okay, any comment?
No.
Okay, thank you, Mademoiselle. Majd, come here, Majd. After him. Quickly, amen, quickly.
I would have to choose always have faith, because if you read the Bible and you don't like that, you think that the story is not real, you can just pray and you'll think the story is real.
Very good. So have faith in what you read. He said something important. Trust the word of God. If God is I am with you, then you have to believe he is with
you.
Okay. Come, Steve.
I choose number 3. Go to God and he'll provide. Because if you're poor and you don't have anything and you pray to God, he'll give you what you need.
Yeah. God is our provider. It's not for the poor. For the poor and rich. Because God is our provider. Thank you, Habib. Come.
Always have faith. When we're in our house and someone closed the light, we could just do the sign of the cross, and God will be with us.
I love you. This is the impact of the family. The family taught him when the light ran out, then he has to have the sign of the cross, and he will have faith. I love this. John, come. Okay.
Number 2, always have faith, because whenever I have a test on like Spanish or something, I worry, because Spanish is a different language, and then I pray to God, and then I start.
Yeah, pray to God and trust he will help you. He will let everything you study stick to your mind. Right? I love you. Okay. Steve. Listen, stay quiet, stay quiet. I will have 3 more and we will conclude. Okay, Steve, a big one, huh? Yeah.
And Joseph. A big one would be number 6, don't tell God what to do. I feel like a lot of the time when we pray, we're asking, we're telling God, I would like this, I want that. When in reality, God, he knows what's best for us, so we shouldn't tell him what's good for us. He knows what's better for us.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Yalla, Bavli, yalla, Bavli, Yusuf, and Joe, and Joseph. After him. quickly, please.
Again, I'm focusing on when you read the Bible, it's not just a blessing of the words, it's a life. Turn the words of the Bible into practice, exercise. Yes.
I'm going to go with number 14, Jesus is God.
Yes, explain to me this.
When I come every Sunday to take communion, I impart the body of Jesus, who is God.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so I'm going to...
You believe?
Yes.
And what is in this miracle shows us Jesus is God?
In this one?
Yeah.
Who else but God could turn 5 loaves and 2 fish to feed a multitude that big?
We call it a miracle of what?
Faith. Yeah.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, miracle of creation.
He created food to feed all of this. Thank you.
No. Theological. Yusuf. Joseph, be ready so you don't have to take time.
So I'm going to go with 3. Go to God and he'll provide. Because most of the time we tend to like think about like what are we going to do when stressed and just overwhelmed with like daily life, and we forget that it's all in God's hand and it's God's will.
So God can take care, right? And he has solution. All, Bob Shinoda always taught us this. Some people, they have keys. God has the master key. You know the master key does what? Open every door. Okay, you will come after him, Cook.
I think number 12 is important because before God does his part, you need to do your part by
what happened to your voice?
By praying, fasting, communion, and confession.
Do your part, which is grace and the struggle. Pray, fast, read the Bible, Matanias, come early to liturgy. Thank you. Allah.
I'm going to do number 4. On the like sense of quiet time reading the Bible, but quiet time in knowing like that God, if he doesn't give you an answer right away and he's silent, that means that is the answer. And that means you have to have patience and you have to wait until, like, you have to trust in God, obviously, having faith. And,
Thank you.
So, to conclude, thank you. Thank you, everybody. Come. Usually raise your hand. You give us a few points. Tell us what you want to choose.
I'm going to choose number 4. Yeah. Importance of quiet time.
Oh. Explain it.
So, like, if they're reading the gospel, you need to be quiet and don't talk.
And if you pray?
And if you pray, like...
Be quiet.
Be quiet.
And when you come to church...
You whisper.
Quiet talk, you whisper.
What do you think about quiet time in church during liturgy? Huh? You sit quiet or keep talking to girls? Huh? I love you. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. You exceeded my expectations. You are doing great. The lesson today was to teach you how to take a life from the words of God in the Bible. When you read the Bible, you take something to apply in your life. Not just reading and forgetting what you read, okay? And you apply it to your life, and your life will change. Like most of you talked about, have faith. Then I don't see any of you scared or troubled or whatever. Or you talked about do your part. Then you have to put efforts or obey God or quiet time. We talked about more than 15 points from a few verses to show you the richness of the scripture in your life. I hope each one of you got something today to apply in his life and to change. To what? To change. The target, the objective is to change. What you do wrong, and read in the Bible. I wish all of you read the Sermon on the Mountain, Matthew 5, 6, and 7. Three chapters summarize a lot of things. If you read it, you will get a lot of teaching out of them. And try to take it and apply it on your life. And glory be to God forever. Amen.